My name is Kate Henshaw.
My name is Amar Kamada.
My name is Maxwell Simba.
Buntle Muloi.
I am Kagiso Ludiga.
Malenga Mlendema.
Chi Mande.
My name is Scott Smith.
Busisiwe Dindili.
Kunleya Falayo.
My name is Timbile Kolapul Tusi.
My name is Dorothy Gituba.
Akimoto Shaw.
My name is Bernard Madison.
Nosifo Dumisa.
My name is Genevieve Naji.
My name is Khaupale Mikabe.
My name is Moabudu.
I think it's time. Been time. It's exciting. You know, a lot of people talk about it's going to be nice to see people who look like me, and people have been confused by that because we've been seeing black people on television. But I think a lot of people don't realize that Africa also has Indian people, white people, mixed race people. I'm really looking forward to having people see Africa as we are.
Having Netflix here as another form of distribution is a good thing for especially upcoming artists who want a chance.
It's a dream come true, such a privilege. It's an honor to be working with, you know, amazing seasoned actors who I've looked up to literally for the longest time, and to actually share this platform with them, I think it's really, really dope. I've learned so much as well. So yeah, I'm very, very excited.
For me, it means something because it's just a way of saying we recognize the people, the talent, what they're about, and the originality of, I mean, who they are.
It's very exciting. It's a momentous time for Africa. It's a great time for Netflix to be here in Africa and to showcase the talent, the creativity, the stories that Africa has to tell. So bringing all the storytellers, all these creatives together is a highlight for sure, for me and for the company.
When I started Ebony Life Television, I said that it was important that we bring together a global black audience. So bringing together Nigerians and Kenyans and South Africans is really, truly the essence of why I started Ebony Life Television. And I think that what Netflix is doing is bringing all of us together to ensure that our stories are understood from state to state, from country to country, from nation to nation. Absolutely.
It's about time, but also, as somebody who's had a film that kind of went onto the local circuit, onto cinema, and it did okay, you know, slightly less than okay. If okay was here, it was kind of like there. And when it got onto Netflix, it immediately got streamed to millions of people. Like literally, when I heard the numbers, I was like blown away. It was just, yeah, unbelievable that one can put a piece of content on this platform and it can immediately be accessible to so many people from all over the world.
Yeah, I'm very excited to be working with such a great group of talent from across the subcontinent. You know, it's a real honor to be with them, and some of these guys have produced some of the greatest shows that has come out of the continent in the last few years. Great directors, great actors and actresses. Very, very happy to be working with them.
I think just being on the set with everybody and experiencing the behind the scenes, I mean, the in front of the camera, because I'm normally behind the scenes, is pretty, pretty dope.
So for me, the fact that Netflix has come to Africa really is exciting. It's terrifying because we don't know the diverse, energetic, and powerful stories that are going to come from this continent, because it means we are going to shape the destiny of where the world is going to.
Well, we don't have a title for it yet. It's going to be very interesting. The costumes are going to be truly original, like Netflix likes original content. My role in the series is Wumi, and she's a lead cast.
I think it was a challenge for me to put myself in that headspace and really have to work with the actors, have to work with the other creators in the team. And I think the writing process itself became a huge collaboration in trying to get to the heart and the truth of the story while still bringing what I think I'm good at, which is genre. I understand that and I love it. It's what I've grown up on, and it's what a lot of my team, our core team at Gamba Films, has grown up on too.
We experience similar things despite being from different continents and all that. So my story that is told in my Africa is from my perspective, who'll be able to influence someone maybe in North America, South America differently based on, you know, how they've lived their lives. And also it could be an eye-opening and an awakening call to, you know, things that are happening to different parts of the continent.
I think African content will resonate because we are also human. And I think as storytellers, we're trying to ask questions, explore themes in our own community. So it's not like we're an alien group of people that nobody will understand. I mean, we are human, we're on the planet, we're part of the global race. So it's doesn't make sense for people to feel that, oh no, they won't connect to Africa. I mean, we're part of the rest of the world. So I think it's the same thing as all other storytellers. We're just trying to tell our stories, explore our lives, and the communities that we live in. So it should not be a strange thing for Africans to be able to tell their stories through their own voices and perspectives.
A good story is a good story. And a really good story is universal. And so I think that our stories, the stories that come out of South Africa, out of Nigeria, out of Uganda or Kenya, I think there's stories that that people can relate to, because really at the heart of it, it's about human beings trying to make a better life for themselves.
South African and Nigerian content will resonate with the world because the content has always resonated. Tsotsi won an Oscar many years ago. We've intervened in world cultural affairs from time. So what we're seeing here is not like the beginning. There's a continuum of the work. But what we have is the opportunity that the world sees it in a way that they haven't seen it before.
The world originated here. Everybody comes from here. There's no way it won't touch them. African content has always been out there, but it's always been through a certain lens or a certain part of one window of the entire mansion of the content.
South African content will definitely connect with the rest of the world simply because it is one of one. And one of one is intriguing to the rest of the world. It's incomparable to anything else. There is no value you can put on it. It's colorful. It is vibrant. It's versatile. It's not stagnant in any way. It moves. It's loud. It's passionate.